Toggling the visibility of a secure field in SwiftUI isn't as straightforward as it seems, because SecureField doesn't provide a built-in support for showing and hiding its contents dynamically. Unlike TextField, which displays plain text, SecureField is locked into secure mode, meaning you can't simply toggle a boolean to reveal the password. That's why in this video, I will walk you through a hands-on example of how to implement a secure and user-friendly toggle using SwiftUI's components the right way. You will see exactly how to switch between secure field and text field while keeping the UI smooth and intuitive. Make sure to check out the discounted link in the description for SwiftUI Camp, my 4-week Zoom bootcamp for only $199. Go ahead and check it out if you want to learn SwiftUI the easy way. So, we are going to talk about the secure field. Let me just open up this Xcode project that I have prepared right over here. And it's just a simple one. So, secure field with a title of password, and we have this binding to the state of password, and I set it, the text field side, to rounded border so we can see it a little bit easier right over here. So if we tap over here and just type, start typing in 1, 2, 3, whatever, our password, it's a secure field, so we have these nice dots over here, so we can't see it. But maybe as I type it out, or maybe when I'm setting my password, I want to see what I'm typing right over here. Currently, it's not possible, so we don't have any switch for the secure field by default in SwiftUI. So let's build that out today. I want to have an eye right over here, an icon that if I tap on, it's just going to show the contents of the secure field. Well, not actually, but you will see how we are going to build this view out. So we have the secure field. It cannot actually show our input. What can is the text field. So let's put the text field onto our secure field, but as a Z stack. So Z stack, because we are going to hide and show the proper one. So we have the Z stack right over here. Let's just see that. There we go. And then secure field, and let's just have our text field. Yeah, let me just copy it out and paste it right over there. You know, it's basically the same thing. And now if I tap over here, because it's on top, I can actually, well, let's just see, did it? No, it's a secure field, sorry. Text field, there we go. So let's move a little bit the text field down so it's on top. And then we just type out 1, 2, 3. There we go. It's simple text field. And I also moved the text field style right over here at the bottom. Great. So I'm going to move it back because the initial value should be our text field. But I want to add in an actual eye. So that a button right over here. So instead of using this text field, let's just use the text field style for now. But we are going to have a horizontal stack, and we are going to use the text field and the secure field and that image. So right over here, we are going to have a horizontal stack. And then we are going to set a button. Let's just have a button right over here with an action and a label. Now the action, we are just going to toggle it. But for now, let's just have the label image. Image with the system name and then I dot slash. That's great now. Okay, and now we can see that the text field style of rounded border doesn't really look okay right over here. So let's fix that. We are going to add, instead of having the text field style right over here, I'm going to add it onto the horizontal stack. And let's just add a little bit of padding. And that would be dot horizontal and 12. Now, this is arbitrary. You might want to change these numbers. I'm just going to go for whatever I felt that looks really nice. Another padding of vertical. And instead of 8, let's just choose 9. And then we're going to have an overlay. So dot overlay with a content. And that would be a rounded rectangle with a corner radius. This one. And let's just have it, 7 would be fine. And then let's just add a stroke with content and line width. It should be right over here. So the content would be a color dot secondary. There we go. And then the line width, let's just go with one, so it's actually being shown. Great. So yeah, it looks really nice, and we have the button right over here, and then we can just type in here our password. As you can see now, it's on top of each other. It doesn't look really nice. We need to set up our logic next. Want to level up your SwiftUI game? Come join SwiftUI Camp, my fun, fast-paced Zoom bootcamp where you learn how to build real iOS apps and actually get SwiftUI. It's all live, hands-on, and made to help you feel confident whether you're building your own app or just hunting for jobs. Right now, you can jump in for 80% off, but that deal is only going to last till May the 7th. Grab your spot while it's hot. Link is in the description. So, I want to remove the actual styling right over here. So I'm going to go and add the button style of dot plain. Okay, so this will not be blue. It's going to be just the default one. Again, these are just styling options. And now we are going to set up an actual is shown state variable at state private. Is showing password. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, let's just go with is showing password. Rather is just is showing because yeah, you might not just use the password right over here. So when we are going to tap on the button, this will toggle it, obviously, toggle, and then let's adhere to it. So first of all, it's just going to toggle it, but we should remove the I dot slash. So instead of this one, we are going to, let me just copy it out and add a new one. So is showing. If it is showing, then we are going to use the I dot slash, otherwise just the I. And now let's just check it out. There we go. It's really, really nice. As you can see, it's just sliding between those two views. Great. Also, I want to switch between the text field and then the secure field. And I'm not going to go with an if-else statement because that is going to remove the whole view and, you know, put another one instead of it. And the text field height and the secure field height is different. So instead, I'm going to go with an opacity. So on the text field, I'm going to go dot opacity and then is showing. And actually, it's the other way around, 1 and 0. And then let me just copy it out and duplicate it and then just set it to 0 and 1. Okay, so now we should start off with the simple password. So 1, 2, 3, 4, it's right over there. We can't see it. What I want to do is just show it. So I'm just going to tap over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and maybe just add 5 over there and then just hide it. Showing and hiding. It's really, really nice. As you can see, it's really straightforward. But it has some quirks. You know, we have to set up the is showing and then all of the buttons, the overlay of the rounded rectangle. So we have that nice rounded border. I want to create a custom view for that. So let's just do that real quickly at the end of this episode. So let's just have a struct right over here, visible secure field. Why not? And it will be a view. And let's just move our stuff, this part over here. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to remove the text field style. Yeah, and also it's a good thing to have right over here a spacer. So it's just going to push out. This will make sense when you are typing in a lot of letters. So a lot of words right over there for, you know, your password. And let's set this to 0. And then is showing, we have that missing. So we can just copy this out and also paste it in there. And then there is this password. So that should be a binding. The actual text that we are using should be on the content field or whatever you are using, the visible secure field. So let's just have a binding at binding var text, just a simple text, and that will be of type string. And then instead of password here, we're just going to use text, and then also text right over here, and everything stays the same. This is really nice. Oh, there we go. So now we are going to use our visible secure field with a text, and we are going to now bind the password. So $password, and we should see the same exact outcome. So if I type in 12345, there we go. I want it to be shown, hidden, shown, and maybe I just add some more and then hide it again. So this is how you make a visible secure field. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out SwiftUI Camp, where you can learn in 4 weeks SwiftUI from beginner to intermediate, let's just say that, the easy way. The discounted link is down in the description.